number one news radio, and weather is always on our mind as we try to figure out what's going on with the weather forecasts. And all along the country, we are seeing information about weather patterns. And, you know, you always want to make sure you have an idea of what's happening where your families are located. You don't want to make sure in case there's a hurricane or anything like that, you're able to get in contact with them. We have on the phone line right now the Public Affairs Director for FEMA, Raphael Lemaitre. And good morning to you. How are you doing?
Hi, Carol. Hi, Jeff. How are you guys?
We are well. Thanks for taking some time with us this morning to talk about the FEMA app. And you're in Washington, D.C. this morning?
I am, and I've been listening to you guys talk about all sorts of fun things, including fire safety and the oyster eating challenge, which sounds really fun.
Well, unfortunately, we're all booked up on contestants, or else we would have had you come and join us. It is something to be seen for sure.
Yeah, you know, I wish I could be out there for it. I don't know if I can beat out any of you guys, but maybe next time I'm in the state, I'll try and stop by.
Wonderful. So we're talking today about the FEMA app. It's a new app from FEMA, and I just downloaded it on my phone. It's available for Apple devices and in the Google Play Store. What are some of the features about the FEMA app? Well, why should people get this on their device?
Yeah, well, you know, we're going into the 4th of July weekend, as you guys have been talking about, and you know, there's a lot of things that as families we're busy with. We're planning vacations. We're dealing with soccer games, going to work, those kinds of things. And sometimes it's hard to just to sit down and plan for the types of disasters that those of us here at work at FEMA see all the time. You know, the big hurricanes get all the news, but, you know, even just things like severe weather or localized flooding can be a huge hassle to a lot of Americans. And the truth is that when it comes to being prepared, the government can only do so much. So what we try to do is we see this as a shared responsibility between those of us at the federal, state, and local level and families and households themselves. So we developed this app to give folks kind of one-stop shopping on everything you'll need to know before, during, and after any kind of disaster. It's a really cool app that has a whole bunch of features built into it.
When I first logged into it, it asked for notification allowance to give me notifications, and the first thing it says, set up a smoke alarm battery change notification. That's a pretty good one to remember, as it often slips your mind.
Yeah, you know, the fire safety is a huge, huge deal, and that's actually the newest feature we've built into the app, where the app will actually send you a little push reminder to check the batteries on your smoke detector, but also other tips, too, like building an emergency kit. The advice that we try to give folks is to have 3 days of food, water, and other supplies in their house so that they can survive on their own for at least 3 days without any help. And so we've built that feature in to make it just a little bit easier for folks to prepare and remind them to do that.
Just 2 weeks ago or so here in the Shelton area, we were part of the Cascadia Rising earthquake drill that was a big deal all along the coast. And so we've been having a big focus on what we need to do and to be aware that this is a when situation, not an if situation. Does it have details and information on what you can do to stay safe in in all types of emergencies?
Yeah, and that's just the thing. This is basically a Swiss Army knife of everything you'll need before, during, and after any type of disaster, from earthquakes to hurricanes to tornadoes. And you know, I know folks in your area now, thankfully, are thinking about what to do in case of an earthquake, and that's great. But this is an app that, if you're on travel, especially over the 4th of July weekend, or visiting friends or family elsewhere around the country, it'll actually give you tips on other types of disasters that impact your area. So if you're on the East Coast, hurricanes obviously a bigger threat in our part of the country. But the other interesting thing about the app is that we've built in a functionality so that you can actually get alerts from the National Weather Service pushed straight to your phone for up to 5 different locations. So let's say there is a flash flood warning or other natural disaster that the National Weather Service is advising you on. You'll get the alert on your phone, but then it'll also give you the option to follow a link so that you can actually take the action you need to do to stay safe and keep your family safe. And if you have friends or family members that live elsewhere around the country, you can kind of keep tabs on them to make sure that they're taking steps as well to stay safe.
When you have, when you can click on the submit disaster photos link on the app, where do those photos go and what would be the point of that?
That's a really cool crowdsourcing feature we've built into the app. So one of the things that we rely on for information in terms of what's happening on the ground sometimes is individuals themselves who may be in areas that have been impacted. So when you submit a photo through the disaster reporter feature, it gets uploaded to us here at FEMA. We take a quick look and moderate the picture, and then we share it back on the app so that folks can see the types of damage that may have occurred during a disaster. Of course, we never want to be in a position where we're having to recover for a disaster, but we know these things happen. So the app is actually not just a preparedness app, but if you are in a declared county that was declared a disaster by the president and you're eligible for certain types of federal help, the app will actually help you register for assistance. It'll help you register with FEMA so you can get the process started to get back up on your feet and recover from whatever happened.
Very nice. It's again free, available in the App Store and the Google Play Store. Just search for the FEMA app, and we're talking with Public Affairs Director Raphael Lemaitre. And thank you so much for calling us and letting us know about the app this morning, and have a great 4th of July weekend.
Same with you guys, and have fun with the oyster eating.
Oh, we surely will. Thank you much.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 717 now, iFiber One News Radio.
Road to the White House, a potential VP candidate for Donald Trump.
Donald Trump has told me that he's narrowed his list of potential running mates, and multiple sources tell ABC News.